Hey everyone, here's a quick video on unit conversion. We're just going to start with simple conversion, just a one-step conversion, and then we're going to build on that one step to a two-step conversion. So like we've done in class, we're talking about copper, gold, and silver. And an example from class we had 240 silver, and we wanted to know, well, that is equal to how much gold. Okay, so silver and gold. Before we can get started, what we need to know is we need to know the relationship between silver and gold. How many silver is worth one gold? What is that ratio? Well, I do know that one gold is the same as 10 silver. Okay? And some background information we need to know is that whenever I take two values or two numbers of the same value and divide them, well, I get one. So since these are equal, what I can do, I can say one gold divided by 10 silver. Well, because those two have the same value, this fraction turns out to be equal to one. Whenever you divide something by the same thing, it is equal to one. So let's keep this in mind, okay? Keep this in mind because we're going to need that for over here. To convert our silver into gold, we could just say, well, one is 10, that means divide by 10. Yeah, okay. But I need to know why. This is why. A little bit more background information. If I take anything and multiply it by one, does it change? No, it stays the same. So if I have 240 silver and I timed all that silver by one, do I have any more silver? No, I still have the same amount of silver because I've just timed it by one. What I can do though is I can say 240 silver and I'm going to times it by one, but instead of one, I'm going to make a substitution. Remember this one here? Well, I'm going to substitute this one in for all of that. Okay, so I have one gold over 10 silver. We know that those two are exactly the same because we've shown it that they are the same. Divided by each other, you get one. One, this here, all of this is equal to one. So if I times it by one, nothing changes. Or if I here times it by one gold over 10 silver, technically this is one, therefore it doesn't change. Now that I have this set up, what I can do is I can start my cross simplification. Now I know that this is technically over one, therefore I have, let's see here, silvers, they can cross simplify. I have my 10, can cross simplify with that 10 over there, and that's about it. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna rewrite. I have 24 times one gold, and that's all over, well, that's all over one. Now, if I have one gold 24 times, how much gold do I have? That's right, I have 24 gold. Okay, therefore, I can make my final statement that 240 silver is equivalent to 24 gold. Okay, and there you have it. These are simple unit conversions using ratios to convert from one to another with only one step. Join me in the next video where we're going to do a two-step, and then the one afterwards will have 3, 4, 5-step unit conversions. See you there.